If you are saying amen, say better amen. In this Ember month, God will preserve you from all evil. In this Ember month, God will preserve you from all evil. In the name of Jesus Christ. A 419 called me yesterday. He said, Pastor Tony. I said, yes. He said, we just left the church now. They told us you have been transferred. I said, yes, for good. It's okay. I'm now working in so and so place. I said, I'm in Lafayette. He now said, I don't want anybody to know. I want you to go to so and so place. He knew I was about to release a curse. He just switched off the phone. Hear me. Contract can't entice me. The next thing I will have roared in tongues with curses for him. May nobody trap you this season. That was how one called me that he's now working in Shell, that he wants to do me a favor for praying for him. I said, you are stupid. If I pray for you, you get the job. The same leg that you use in walking to meet me in the office, that's the same leg you use to walk to come back. You don't need to tell me to come and meet you so and so place. He switched off the phone, and that line is no longer in use. May nobody trap you this season. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. If it were to be something with the center, open door. It's no open door. We are going to pray. A sister sent me a text that the husband was in a vision. Two men say that it's time to take her. Scripture says, your covenant of death shall be disannulled, and the agreement with hell shall not stand. Anywhere an evil plan has been made, put yourself in the picture. We're only using it as a point of contact. Anywhere an evil plan has been made, an occultic agreement has been decided, a satanic injunction has been passed over you, by the blood of Jesus and by the fire of the Holy Ghost, let that plan and the altar scatter. Lift up your voice and turn that into your prayer right now. Any evil altar, any evil plan, every occultic decision that has been taken against anyone in this church, against me, against my wife, against my children, against my brothers, against my sisters, against my mother, against my relations, Father, by the blood of Jesus, by the fire of the Holy Ghost, whoever those two men represent spiritually, I release the dagger of Oyedepo against them. Every ancestral devil, ancestral strongman, occultic witchcraft, by the fire of the Holy Ghost, by the blood of Jesus, I command their destruction. Let their plans scatter. Let their invocations scatter. Let their altar scatter. Le kotobre teteri jetuna enseza ekoteto Jesus e holy he topash nasetro pledi shetorias lanso brengledi shatoris. Lead the bouquet, you shall not die. Wherever that decision was taken, I scatter it by fire. Laboros, le cotebre sozeneres, in zodoroto kutapash, jeklepe bredi sotalosh, naso tekleriatash. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Whoever marked you out to be wasted, let them go for you in the name of Jesus. Whatever looked like an evil decision passed over your head, over your life, I withdraw your name by fire. I replace their name by fire. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we pray. Congratulations. God bless you. Get seated. Engaging the power of the Holy Spirit for conquest. Part 3. And this teaching will be focusing on Holy Spirit is the spirit of love. I like to begin by saying that your nature determines your ultimate future. If you walk with a bad nature, you will end up with a bad future. At new birth, your spirit man is born again. Your flesh is not born again. You are only going through what we call regeneration. If a man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away and all things are become new. Romans 12 and verse 1, brethren, I beseech you by the mercies of God that you present your body as a living sacrifice, which is your reasonable service. He said, do not therefore conform to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. The renewing of your mind is what brings about the engraftment of the nature of Christ. That's why somebody can be in church and be thinking evil, because his mind has not been regenerated. Somebody can be in church and be planning how somebody will fall into evil. Why? Because he has not been conformed to the image of the Son of God. And I want to let you know, until you are growing in the nature of God, in the love of God, you cannot manifest your ultimate destiny. Your ultimate destiny is at the mercy of the love of God that is in you. But scripture revealed it to us. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, nor has he entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for them that love him. So as you are growing in love, you are growing in revelation. God is opening to you what he has in mind for you. He's revealing to you where he's taking you to. He's showing you the things that are about to come to pass for you. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, not as he entered into the heart of man, what God has prepared for them that love him. You don't reveal your secret to someone that doesn't love you. You can never try it, even naturally. In fact, someone that doesn't love you, if good is coming, you withdraw it. Why? In your heart of hearts, you have known that this person doesn't love you. God operates the same principle. Draw near unto me and I will draw near unto you. As you are drawing nearer to God, he checks your heart. There are people that love you because of what they want to get from you, not because they truly love you from their heart. The Holy Ghost has one mission: to fuel and increase us in the love of God. Hear me, what we call the love of God is not mouth. It's act, it's practice, it's demonstration. Scripture says the love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit. So there is a seed of love planted in my heart, planted in your heart by the Holy Spirit. But hear me, for that seed to grow, we must create a habitation. David said, I will prepare a habitation for my God. You must make the seed comfortable to grow. Any seed planted in a choky ground will die. True or false? Jesus said, if ye abide in my love, he said, I and my Father will come and make ourselves manifest in thee. You lack divine manifestation if you are not growing in love. You may be born again, but you will suffer like Jackie. Do you know why? You're not growing in love. The love of God cannot be faked. The love of God is superior to activity. You can be active and not be productive. So when the love seed is nurtured, it guarantees your ultimate future. You can't be growing in love for God and divine manifestations not take place around your life. It will be noticed. Because what takes place within determines what takes place outside. So when love is found in your heart, it creates an invitation for the wonders, for the acts of God. Hear me? What love cannot do, God cannot do. God is limited when love is out of place. It takes the love of God to win, to be triumphant, to subdue challenges, to overcome temptation. The Holy Ghost cannot share the love of God in your heart if you are not drawing closer to God. Who you draw closer to determines what pumps into you. Let me take a very clear example now. Pastor, come. If you are drawing closer to me, there must be a transference. There must be an impartation. I must be saying something to you. And what I'm saying to him is inducing him. Am I correct? I'm either inducing him positively or I'm inducing him negatively. And whatever I am inducing into this man, very soon you will see him manifest it. Go and sit down. If someone is speaking evil to you, we don't need 3 days prayer and fasting for you to manifest the evil. Let the person keep speaking to you. Very soon you will reflect the person. Very simple. It's something you cannot fake. Association is contagious. No association leaves you on the same spot. Is it that driving you towards loving God or towards loving evil? Somebody can be association with you secretly. We don't even need to know the person's name. In no distant time, we'll begin to see your manifestations. Why? Someone has been influencing you secretly. We don't need to know the person's name. But very soon, we'll begin to see the person's product in your life. The Holy Ghost cannot be fueling you with the love of God without fellowship with God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and our fellowship. And our fellowship. Now, there is power in fellowship. Oh. How many of us know Jehoshaphat? You have read about Jehoshaphat? God himself said, you shall not need to fight in this battle. I, the Lord, shall fight for you. Jehoshaphat now had another fellowship. A bad fellowship. Do you know what God said? Since thou have joined thyself with Ahaziah, I will break thy sheep. Fellowship. You can enter another sheep. Let's read it from the Bible. 2 Chronicles 20 from verse 35. And after this, did Jehoshaphat, king of Judah. It's still the same chapter 20. Join himself with Ahaziah, king of Israel, who did very wickedly. And he joined himself with him to make ship to go to Tarshish. And they made the ships in Ezion Geba. Then Eleazar, the son of Dodova of Marasha, prophesied against Jehoshaphat. You can be prophesied for and be prophesied against. In the same chapter. Saying, because thou have joined thyself with Ahaziah, the Lord hath broken thy works. And thy sheep were broken, that they were not able to go to Tarshish. May nobody puncture your journey in life. Everybody here now knows the sheep. Because whoever you are listening to, following, is your sheep. Friendship. Fellowship. You are in one sheep. Relationship. Are you wrong saying that? Either it is friendship or fellowship or relationship or what? Or courtship. Before you know what's happening, they are cutting you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I learned from Dr. Paul Enenche. Relationship enhances the quality of destiny or degrades or reduces the quality of destiny. Every relationship is either moving you towards loving God, loving his house, and loving his people, or it is moving you away from loving God to being carnal, hating his people. You now become a witchcraft in church. We call them charismatic witchcrafts. How do I know you are a witchcraft in church? When they are not telling you, sending evil messages to you about a brother or a sister, and you are now, come. I'm not, my example are the give. This brother, WhatsApp this person. You stand up, stand here. This one, WhatsApp this person. The witchcraft is increasing. This one, WhatsApp this mama. So they have formed a network of four witchcrafts. They are not spreading good, they are spreading evil. You are a witch. The only difference is that you have not started flying in the night. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Am I lying, Pastor? The only difference is that you have not gotten a pot, a calabash, a small mirror. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? The essence of shedding the love of God in our heart is to increase our passion for God. And your passion for God determines your portion of good. If you are reducing in your passion for God, you are also reducing your portion of good. makes us to be more than conquerors. 1 John 4 verse 16, we need to read that scripture. 1 John 4 verse 16. And we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love. And he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God and God in him. If God is in you, he doesn't need announcement. He will see it. Am I correct? He doesn't need announcements. Paul said, you are the epistles that men read. The love of God can be seen. It can be felt. It's touchable. It's feelable. Romans 8 and verse 35. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long, and we are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Verse 38 now. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angel, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, neither height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. So the love of God does not take you away from God, but rather it draws you closer to God. The Lord is with you while you are with him. If you forsake him, he will also forsake you. Hear me? Every time you begin to reduce in your love for God, things begin to grow hard for you. We read it last Sunday. 1 Chronicles 15. For a long time, they were without a teaching priest and without the law. And scripture said, a great vexation was upon the people. And the Lord gave them all around adversity. So every time you are reducing in your love, you become vulnerable to challenges. You are easily overwhelmed by problems. Why? The love of God has left you. But if God be with you, nothing can win you. Challenges will come, you will win them. Problems will come, you will subdue them. So growing in love is getting addicted to the nature of God. Hear me? You can't carry the love of God and not carry the presence of God. And the presence of God has the power to humiliate challenges, to diffuse tension. So our chance of being triumphant in life, in situations, in circumstances, number one ingredient is the love nature. Love is unkillable. The love of God is undiable. The scripture said again, perfect love casted out all fear. Anything you are doing in fear, the love of God is not there. Anything you are doing in hiding, don't let him know. Don't let him know. I just want to inform you. The love of God is not there. He's a devil. If what he's showing you, open it. Let's see. Confront the person with it. I've not said this before. Let me say this now. If you come to tell me anything about any person, get ready. I will call you. I will also tell the person. Are you hearing me now? Anything you don't want me to ask the person, don't tell me. Are you hearing me now? I'm just telling you for your information. It's an evil information. Don't tell me the person is bad. Can I ask him? This is what you said. Somebody came when I was in Refi. That was exactly the first month. You know, when a pastor is new in a place, evil people besiege him. So he came. I allowed him to finish talking. And funny enough, the person I've been to my office before, I just sent a message. Please, I want you, Nana. I want you, Nana. The person just came. So he now told me, I'm here, sir. I said, come in. I didn't allow the person to go. I said, yeah, repeat what you said. He started sweating by force. Are you hearing me now? Do you know why? I repeat what you said. Hearing from one source make you a devil. If you want to establish a truth, hear from the two. Somebody can tell you something, it will be very sweet. Can I ask the other person? I said this without fear of anybody. Anything anybody tells you or gives you a message about me and you cannot confront me, you and the person, you are a coward. If what the person is telling you is true, please be bold to confront me. Be bold. After telling me, I can give you Papa's number or Bishop Abiyah's number or Pastor James's number so that you can relay the same. That's how many people have killed church. Killed love. Spoiling another person doesn't make you triumphant. Neither does it establish your own good nature. It only exposes the wickedness in you. And you can only do it to fools like you that swallow evil like you. Scripture said, do good to the household of God, not evil to the household of God. I beg you, and I tell you the truth, I want to make heaven. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Just don't want to be shouting, shout hallelujah, shout hallelujah. And on that day, my name no day there. God forbid, Barty. My name was there. So anything that needs to be confronted, I will confront it. If you say I've done anything, come, let's come. Say it in the open. I told my, anywhere I go, I say this. So I told church board, stand up. SEC, stand up. Deacons board, stand up. FMC, stand up. Which other one? Audit, stand up. Any day you hear say, Pastor, they toast one girl, report me. Report me to the person, to those three people. Let them, they have power to confront me. Make sure you have your facto and all your details. If not, you don't carry cause. So dwelling in love, the reason why I'm saying this, the scripture said there is no fear in love. Perfect love casted out all fear. Anything you are doing in hand, the hiding, there is the love of God is not in it. Sister is in a relationship. He doesn't want anybody to know. Something there inside. Let's go and tell Pastor. For what now? Is Pastor your father? Yes, he's my spiritual father. Just 2 weeks ago, a sister told me that she is in a relationship with one brother. And I told the brother, okay, let's go and see Pastor. He said, should we have transferred Pastor now? He said, okay, can't we talk to him on phone? He said, for what now? I said, enter lane one. Take off for your life. Any person that does not want your father or your mentor to know what is happening, danger day. And if you cover them, The day that danger go open. There is an adage my father used to give. Love is like a package. When you buy it, when you go home, anything you open and see inside, now you buy them. Perfect love casted out all fear. Don't do anything that fear, that you will not be able to say to any truthful person. People that walk in love, they walk in truth. People that walk in love, they walk in correction. There are some people, when you correct them now, their face will turn to shit. They won't greet you again. The next thing, they will be sitting at their back so that they will be seeing their face. Or they will be staying at overflow. They will be shouting amen from there. They don't want you to see them. Him that the Father loves, he chastises. Him the Father loves, he corrects. Him the Father loves, he draws near. The reason why he's drawing you near is so that you won't miss it. Any love that does not go with correction, hear me, you have been submitted to evil. Allow him, let him go and die alone. Let him go and kill himself. If they love you, they will correct you. And hear me, you are not growing in love if you see a brother making a mistake, a sister making a mistake, and you don't call the person to correct him. That's not love. It will become an issue of gossip. Very soon. Walking in love empowers us for unlimited access to revelation. I've discovered this with my mentors. They check me to determine what they tell me. They won't tell you everything immediately. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? They won't tell you everything immediately. They will check whether this person is following them with their heart or with their head or with what he wants to get. Likewise, the closer you draw to God in love, the more he reveals to you. He reveals destiny to you. He reveals secrets to you. He reveals divine idea to you. He reveals creative insights to you. Revelation is multidimensional. It is not only one-sided. So every revelation, every secret, every idea you are getting from God is because of your growing love for God. So if there is anything you must do for yourself, nobody will do it for you. You hear me? Love is responsibility. It is your responsibility to grow in the love of God. Your responsibility. Don't say, because this person offended me, I will not grow in love again. Grow in Satan. And you know Satan is waiting to koboko you. Hear me? Don't allow anything that will reduce your love for God. Paul said, "Oh Galatians, who has bewitched you?" He said, "Did you start in the spirit to end up in the flesh?" They started off spiritually, growing in the love of God. All of a sudden, they are growing carnal. Their love for God is beginning to fade. They are losing their spiritual virtue. May you not lose your spiritual virtue. Your love for God determines your height in life. Your love for God determines your height in life. Your progress in life. You can't truly be walking in love and be stranded. You can't truly be walking in love and be limited. You can't truly be walking in love and get to a point where you don't know what else to do. It's a lie. thou shalt hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way, walk here in it. Can you be in love with somebody and the person is watching you stranded, watching you frustrated, watching your business collapse, watching doors shut against you? No! He's only taking advantage of you. God is not taking advantage of us. Whatever he shows to us is because he has love for us. Jesus said, as my Father has loved me, so have I loved you. So we grow in revelation, in progress. Love also determines your dominion. I discovered that creativity is the brainchild of dominion. The more creative you are, the more domineering you become. What does it mean to be creative? New things are coming to pass. New products. Revelation is a product of revelation. Creativity. So, as he's showing you, new things are taking place. Your dominion is getting established. Things are getting done. Why? Love. So, when you are in love, you grow in dominion. You become more forceful. You become more relevant. Your effect cannot easily be wiped away. Walking in love. For everyone that cares to walk in love, you become a pathfinder. Where others go and fail, when you go, you get results. What is difficult for others to achieve, they call it impossible. To you, it's like you are just playing with the team. Why? The one you are working with cannot watch you fail in anything, but rather succeed with it. You become a pathfinder, a trailblazer. And this is one of the secrets of Daniel. Who can interpret this dream? It's a difficult one. It can only be someone that is in love with God that can get that secret. No wonder. When people are looking for things, they look for who is closest to the person. Who can access him without any difficulty. I remember one pastor I worked with. He was my district pastor. He took something to one of our boss. Let me call him Pastor Jeme. He used red biro. Via. Voa. Voa. Threw away the paper. The pastor drove and came and met me in my station. He said, Pastor, I don't know what I've done, but it's like, oh, guy is angry with me. Can you help me with this paper? I said, what did you do? He couldn't explain. The same paper with red biro. I carried the paper. When I presented it, he didn't even look at it, whether it was his red biro. He just wrote, approve, account, treat. I said, sir, it's from this station. He said, why didn't you tell me it's from this station? I said, sir, let mercy prevail. It's okay, go. What I'm just trying to explain to you, when people want to get things done, they look for who is closer to the person. Because if that person goes, the remedy must come out. The solution must come. So when you grow deeper in love with God, you become a solution provider. That was what Daniel was. Daniel had access to the heart of God. So he knew the challenge of the king. So, Lord, what is the problem in Babylon? I want you to reveal it to me so that your name will be glorified. And God revealed it. God revealed it. That's how God will be revealing things to you. Please, I beg you, grow in love. Let me summarize with this. What is love? Love is keeping his commandments. John 14 verse 16. Keeping his commandments. John 14 verse 16. You are looking for John. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give ye another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. The next verse now. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because he seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be with you. So keeping his commandment is walking in love. Love is not talk, love is show. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? What is love? Love is goodwill. Your goodwill is seen, your goodwill is felt. What you send out, if you send out goodwill, you will get goodwill. If you send out badwill, you will get badwill. Anything you send out must come back. So growing in love, walking in love is your choice. Your goodwill is what keeps you in the will of God. Your goodwill is what keeps you in the will of God. You are out of his will when you are not walking in his will. So demonstrate goodwill. Papa said, goodwill to all men. Are you what I'm saying now? Goodwill. Goodwill to all men. If you release this, if you release goodwill, and people are planning evil for you, the evil will fail. I've seen it over and over. Just be releasing goodwill and be canceling their bad will. Rise up to your feet. If you must win in life, grow in love. The more love you carry. Paul prayed, David prayed a prayer. Create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. He said, because thou lovest righteousness and hated wickedness, therefore the Lord thy God has anointed thee above thy companion, because thou lovest righteousness. Righteousness is the nature of God, and your nature determines your future. Love baptize my heart afresh with your love. Every carnal nature, any nature that is not of God, Jesus said, whatsoever my heavenly Father has not planted, let it be uprooted. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer right now. Every carnal nature, let it be uprooted. Every carnal nature, let it be uprooted. Every carnal nature, let it be uprooted. Whatever is limiting my love for God, whatever is making me not to grow in love for God, Lord, let it be uprooted. Let it be uprooted. Your desire is that you will be like Jesus. Lord, uproot anything that is contrary to the love of God. Thank you, Father. You are not praying serious now. If I say pray for one breakthrough now, you will be thundering. Your love nature determines your blessing capacity. You can't be growing in the love of God and be reducing in blessing. Lord, help me to grow in love. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, as we partake of this communion, every contrary nature, by this communion, let it be uprooted. There was a he that eats my flesh and drink my blood. I in him and him in me. Let there be an impartation of your love in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever has reduced our passion for your house, by this communion, let there be a restoration. In Jesus' name we pray.